Hi, this is Jessica with Expressions Vinyl, and today I'm going to show you how to make a t-shirt layout using Silhouette Studio, and I'm going to cut it out with my Silhouette Cameo. I'm going to use the Easyweed heat transfer for my t-shirt. So first, this is what I want to make. There's a few different elements in it, and so I'm going to show you how to put it all together. I'm going to start by clicking on my text, and I'm going to type in happy. And I want to change the font on that. I just downloaded Wolf in the City, and it's been my favorite this week. So make that a little bigger. And as you can see, the red lines are where my machine is going to cut. So I'm going to have a problem if it cuts these little pieces that are running into each other. So I'm going to right click with my mouse, and I'm going to choose weld. And that is just going to make it all one word with no little pieces cut out. I am going to select my text tool, and I'm going to type in camper in all caps. And I'm going to double click and select it all and change my font on that to something just a little more straight. Okay, I'm going to double click it and select it all, and I'm going to space it out a little bit. It's really close together, so I'm going to do like 110%. That looks better. All right, make this bigger. And as you can see over here, I took out my A and did a little tent since we're camping. So I'm going to double click, and I'm going to select that and just delete my A. And then I'm going to put a couple of spaces in there. So, and now I'm going to go to my library, and I'm going to find my little tent, which is right here under my adventure. Okay, so this is another little trick. We'll take him over to his own little space, right click and press ungroup. And now everything's individual, and I can just pop my tent out and drag him over to my camper. And then draw a box over these guys and just delete everything there. Okay, so back over, click on my tent, make him a little bit smaller to fit in there. And then I kind of want to play with my letters here. Get a little more space there for this tent. So I'm going to right click on my word and everything is selected, and I'm going to ungroup it because I want to make my C bigger, a little taller, and then I want to make my E and my R a little bigger, and just select my R and make him even bigger. Okay, and then I'm going to make my tent bigger. So you might want to play with this a little bit till you get it where you want your letters. I think that looks pretty good. Make my tent just a little taller by clicking on this box and just stretching him out a little bit. Okay, now I'm gonna click my left button and drag over that again and select everything, right click and group it back together. So now it will just move all together, which makes sizing and everything a little easier. All right. Now I'm going to go find my Idaho. So I go back to my library, and I'm going to type in states. And there's all my states. So I'm going to do the same thing. Drag this guy over to his own space. Right click, ungroup, and then pull my Idaho out and drag him over. And then select all this and delete him. Okay, so my Idaho looks a little crooked. I'm going to straighten him out with this little green button at the top. Okay, that looks pretty good. And I'm going to make him a little bit bigger. So just stretch him out there in that corner. Okay, now for the tricky part, I'm going to show you how to do the lettering on a curve. So I'm going to go to my text. And I'm going to type in Camp Tiger. Okay. And now I'm going to space this out a little bit. Let's try 135%. That looks pretty good, and we can play with that too. Now I'm going to draw an oval. From my tool, my drawing tools over here. And I'm going to actually make it an oval. Okay. And then I'm going to click on my camp tiger so it's selected. I'm going to double click until this little circle with the plus sign shows up. And I'm going to put my mouse right in the middle there and click and drag it over to the circle. And once this little circle hits my oval, it's going to catch on. So I want it to be on this side. I want it to be in the middle. So you just kind of have to play with it and drag it until it grabs where you want it to. Okay. Now, that looks pretty good actually. So you can double click, you know, and place it where you want on your oval. And I'm going to drag it back over and see how we're doing. And I think I need to move it over just a little bit. Oops. Double click. Select my arrow and drag it. And now I think I want my letters just a little bit closer together, so I'm going to select them. And then I'm going to go over to character spacing. And let's try like 120. 125. Yeah, that looks better. Okay, now those got swished together and I need to center it again. Okay, now what we want to do here is select this, right click, and click on convert to path. And that way I can take my circle away, but my letters stay curved. Okay. And now we're going to add our, it's 2015. Add that into the shirt, shrink it down. And put it in the Idaho. So this can show you all the different things you can do in creating a shirt and really personalize it for yourself. Now we're going to type in the redfish, and I'm going to use lots of spaces and shrink it down. And I'm going to need some more space. You could do redfish in separate letters, but I would like to keep them lined up. An easy way to do that. Okay, so we got the redfish in there. I think I'm going to do a few more spaces still. Okay, click off there and then just adjust it with my arrows where I want them to go. Okay, and now I'm going to go back to my library and find my arrows. So let's show all designs and scroll down. Silhouette Store has a ton of images. So if you're ever in need of one, there's tons you can buy. They also have their free images of the week. Okay, here's a chevron banner. This will work for my arrows. So double click on those and then shrink them down. So they're pointing at Idaho. Okay, and this I also want to keep in line. So I'm going to go up here to my duplicate tool. And I'm going to mirror right. And then I'm going to use my arrows and drag him over. So it'll stay on the same line, evenly spaced. And I'm going to adjust my redfish just a little bit. Okay. So we have our Happy Camper t-shirt ready. And now one trick I like to do is to draw a rectangle. I'm gonna draw a rectangle across my image. And I'm gonna click back on it until all these little boxes show up. And then I'm going to just tighten that up so it's a nice box around all. And this will cut around the image and it just helps with weeding and keeping everything together. Okay, now the most important part, since we are going to do this in heat transfer, is we need to mirror it. But before we can mirror it, we need to group it all together. So we select everything, right click, and group. And then we are going to mirror right. And that makes it a mirrored image. So I'm going to drag this down. We don't need it. And then drag my image back into the corner. And now I am ready to cut it out. So I go up here to my silhouette button, click it. And my cameo is not connected right now, but I will show you in the adjust cut settings what you need to do. So go down under material type. You'll want to find heat transfer material and smooth. And this does have some presets. So speed it is at 8. I would slow that down just a little bit because there's so many different elements in this cut and such little words with the redfish and the 15. Thickness is at a 4. Depending on your blade's age, that's probably great. If it's a brand new blade, I would definitely move it down to a 2 or a 3. There's also this test cut button, which just cuts a little tiny triangle in the corner. And it's a great way to tell if you have your blade set right. And then I would click send to silhouette and have it cut out.